foremost, I want to be able to thank pay-per-view, thank Rock Nation, and definitely my team, and Miguel Cotto, for helping me with this opportunity, and definitely want to be able to make the fans proud and excited to see this match. We're definitely in camp, just as well as Miguel Cotto, and putting on a tremendous show as far as driving to the next limit and making sure there's no limitations to how far to push me to get me to this outstanding victory. Thank you.
Miguel.
I'm happy to be here. I have my camp start 2 days ago, 3 days ago, and I'm committed to this fight. I'm committed to look the best way possible for February 25th, and I'm in charge. Fred is in charge of my camp. Fred is the captain of both, and I trust him, and I know I'm going to be ready for February 25th. Thank you.
We will now open up to questions.
¿Algún mensaje para tu público en español?
No, estoy bien, estoy preparado para el equipo, no preparado, estoy preparado para el combate, pero estaremos listos para el próximo 25 de febrero. Gracias.
Justin was already, he's going to be for the 25th. Of course, he's going to be 100% ready to give us a great fight.
Miguel, habla sobre regresar, regresando al ring después de un año y regresando con Freddy.
The question is about the comeback. You've been out for over a year, and now you're coming back and with Freddy.
Me encuentro bien, gracias a Dios, pues regresamos hace unos días al gimnasio, me he sentido de maravilla, Freddy. Me ha hecho trabajar muy bien y sé que el próximo 25 de febrero no tenemos ningún problema y subiremos en la mejor condición posible para obtener la victoria.
No, I feel real good. I've been working with Freddy for a couple of days. He's putting me through the paces, you know, getting ready. And there's no question in my mind that I'll be at top physical shape for the 25th.
Miguel, ¿esta podría ser tu última pelea? ¿Y qué posibilidad es una revancha con Canelo si es que sigue en el boxeo?
Estamos...
Is this going to be your last fight, or are you close to your last fight, and what about fighting Canelo in the future?
Estamos pensando en James, estamos entrenando para James, estamos poniéndonos listos para el próximo 25 de febrero, y es lo que tenemos en mente, lo que venga después, pues, vendrá después.
Right now, the only thing in my mind is James Kirkman getting ready for the fight, and after that we can think about what's next, or, you know, whatever comes up. But right now, the only thing in my mind is James Griffin.
Hey, Michael, since you've been the promoter and the head of this division, looking at Miguel's next fights, do you have like a time frame of when do you want to see him back in? And do you expect him to be back in? Historically, he's fought in June. Is that going to be the next date?
That's entirely up to Miguel. As he just said, our number one focus is on February 25th. After February 25th, I'm sure Miguel and his team will begin to think about the future, but that's the only thing that we've discussed at this point.
Mm-hmm. Would you like to fight again in June, Miguel?
We'll see. We'll see what happens.
James, you yourself are also coming off a, you know, long layoff. Do you feel this is the perfect fight for both you and Miguel?
I believe it's a tremendous opportunity for myself. As far as from Miguel, I feel like this is going to be a good event, a good opportunity for me and Miguel to be able to take advantage of this opportunity and put on a great fight for the fans.
James, I think a lot of fans are excited knowing that Ann Wolf is going to be in your corner for this fight. What are you looking forward to in this camp, and if any, are there any things you're not looking forward to in this camp?
Dealing with Ann is, I'm not interested in knowing what the next day he'll his health and the training, but when it comes down as far as what to look forward and what to expect out of camp, just to put like there's no limitation to what to go through to get to be able to succeed in for fight time, you know.
Do you feel like she gets you better mentally for a fight?
Definitely when it comes down to mentally preparing myself and physically preparing myself, and definitely knows how to push me to the next limit, it shows.
This is for both fighters. It's no secret that you're closer to the end of your career than the beginning, and you must be thinking about your legacy. If you had to define what you think your legacy is to the sport, what would that be, and how do you see this fight adding to your overall legacy?
When it comes to me, I feel like getting an opportunity to face Miguel Cotto was somebody that I looked up to in boxing and seeing his career. The tremendous change that he has brought to the game, for me to be able to get the opportunity to show what I can bring and take my boxing skills to the next limit, is definitely something that I can definitely put down in my boxing ability and things that I have accomplished in boxing.
And what do you think your career has meant to the sport?
To this point, man, I feel that my career is it definitely needs to get put back on the rise and show that not just to the fans, but to the to boxing itself, the sport of boxing, that Kirkland is definitely a disher. I mean, someone's going to go out there and put on a great show, not just for the fan, but for himself and for the sport of boxing.
And Miguel, the same.
Can you repeat the questions?
Sure. As you look back now for the end of your career at your legacy to the sport, what do you think that is, and how do you think this fight will add to your legacy?
This fight is going to be the newest chapter in my career. I'm going to take it. I'm going to handle it in the best way possible. I'm going to do my best first with Freddie in the gym, and then the night of the fight to make my family proud this time. And then my legacy, I doesn't control, I can't control what people can say about me after I'm retiring, but all I do in life is for my family, for my kids, and that is going to be my legacy, what they think about me.
Miguel, there was a lot of talk before about you fighting Juanma and Marquez. How serious were those negotiations, and what happened that didn't make that fight happen?
We didn't get concrete this fight, and it never happened. That was all.
Were you interested in, was that a real possibility at one point?
I think both parts were interested in this fight.
He said the weight was an issue that you kind of changed your mind towards the end of those negotiations, that's why the fight didn't materialize?
He knew all the time our answer on this chapter, on this topic, and he already knew everything about us.
Miguel, me gustaría tu respuesta sobre la pregunta del legado. ¿Qué querías decir?
No, yo no, es algo que yo no puedo controlar que quiera pensar el público de mí, de boxeo, pero el único legado que me interesa es lo que yo pueda dejar en mis hijos, y es lo único que me interesa.
The question was about the legacy, to do it in Spanish, and he answered it in Spanish.
¿Estaba negociando algo con Manuel Márquez? ¿Puedes hablar un poquito al respecto de eso?
Nunca se concretó, nunca le llegamos a acuerdo con Manuel y yo, así que hemos estado siempre abiertos a negociar con él, así que cuando él quiera, estamos abiertos.
Question was about Marquez fight, and he answered it.
James, when this fight was announced, how did many writers said that this is a roadmap for Cotto to get back to Canelo? Can you speak to your motivation, if you haven't or have not read the articles and it's like, you know, have you heard that?
Honestly, man, whoever Miguel is wanting to face next, or what that fight may help with that next person, is totally up to them. But when it comes down for me and Miguel Cotto, we're focused on February 25th. So writers and the fans or whoever may be entitled to looking at this fight should only be focused on February 25th, because that's when the opportunity for me presents itself, and I'm definitely wanting to put on a good show.
Miguel,
¿cuánto
tiempo más te ves peleando? ¿Tienes algún plazo o simplemente lo que te deje el cuerpo?
Estamos hablando de la pelea, la próxima pelea, el próximo 25 de febrero. Estamos enfocados en ella y no hay cabida en estos momentos para hablar de esos temas. Creo que después de la pelea de febrero 25, pues nos sentaremos y decidiremos hasta dónde y hasta cuándo queremos.
The question is, when do you see yourself fighting for a long time? How long do you think you have? Right now, you know, let's do February 25th. Let's get the fight done, and then we'll think about what's next. But right now, the focus is the 25th, not thinking about anything else.
Como mencionamos, estamos trabajando, estamos en preparación para James Kirkland el próximo 25 de febrero, luego de el 25 de febrero, el 26 de febrero, hablaremos de qué sigue mi carrera.
Obviously, this is your last fight with Rock Nation. Are you going to extend the contract with them? Like I said, all I'm thinking about right now is the 25th, getting the Kirkland fight, getting it done. And on the 26th, we'll see what's next.
James, how grueling is working with Ann Wolf? We heard the stories, you read the things. From your point, how hard is it going through a camp with her, and what do you go through?
Honestly, when it comes to just working with Ann, we have a reputation between ourselves is that I'm definitely going to give my all. And as far as motivation and push me to this next level, she's definitely one of the people that I can say they can bring the best out of me.
James, did you see Miguel's last fight against Canelo? And if you did, what did you make of it? Who you fought won?
I did see them both put on a tremendous show, and I think they did an excellent job as far as who wins and who lost, you know, depends on how everybody else feels about it, you know. I have my picks and what I think and what I may believe, but in boxing, everybody's entitled to their opinion.
I'm interested in what you believe, though. Who did you thought won the fight?
That's not for me to say. Like I said, I just like to see great performance, and they put on a great show.
Miguel, you said that you started training camp about two or three days ago. What's it like to finally be back in camp with Freddie?
It's good. It's good to be back. It's good to be sweating, laugh during the training sessions, and I know with Freddie has everything set for our training camp, and we are going to do it as always, to do it as always February 25th.
And the second part of that question, Miguel, is the time. Have you been like doing some like exercising and training? If so, was it like light training or heavy training?
I've been away from the boxing gym a lot, but I'm always keep myself doing something not related to boxing, but doing something.
Miguel, at this point of your career, is a long layoff like the one you had a benefit?
I rest a lot. I heal everything I got in the last years, and I'm ready to fight.
Miguel, looking back at your soon-to-be Hall of Fame career, what fight would you want to rematch? Who would you want to rematch? And why?
I enjoyed every fight. I did my best in every opportunity. Whatever fight I had, as a game, I know that I will do the same, the best. No.
What about you, Freddie? Who would you want to see in rematch?
You know, obviously I thought he won his last fight, and you know, rematch would be great there. You know, and Miguel told me if I was in this corner with Mayweather, we would have kicked his ass. But I mean, if these guys, you know, what's next? Who knows? But right now we have a tough fight in front of us, and we get ready for that fight. And I did send my guys out a couple times to work with them. Marvin went to visit them, and in Puerto Rico, and Gavin went in a couple times also. And just keep them fresh and not forget entirely about us.
Freddie, obviously you've dealt with this with Pacquiao. Is it difficult to get a veteran fighter up to speed after a long layoff?
You know, everyone's different, of course, but Miguel, the last 2 days, he's been great. You know, we've had a little bit of layoff. We had a little dust off the body pad, and we did yesterday, and the body punches are fucking hard. yes, I beat blood last night. but yeah, it's good to be back to work, and I'm happy to have him back in the gym.
But yeah, do you have designs to fight for another world title, or at this point in your career, is it just maybe one more signature win to kind of cement your legacy?
I don't think about it. You know, I think that I accomplished enough in my career. I'm happy with the way my career being done by everybody around me, and I'm just happy. I'm not thinking about any title. It's in my mind right now.
Miguel, after so many years and so many accomplishments, how is it you still find the hunger to get up there and, you know, take the hits and get up and train?
I'm still having the same kind of mind, you know. I want the best for my guys, my child. I want the best for my family, and that's why I'm here.
Miguel, habla un poco, habló Michael ahorita sobre la asociación con Jerry Jones. Habla usted un poco sobre eso.
Can you talk a little bit about Jerry Jones being part of the promotion?
Entiendo que como menciona Michael, Jerry Jones, el señor Jerry Jones, es una persona que conoce, lleva años con su franquicia de los Dallas Cowboys, y entiendo que es como dice Michael, es el partner perfecto para este evento en Dallas.
You know, like Michael said, Jerry Jones is a great promoter. You know, a lot of respect for his team, the organization of the Dallas Cowboys, and it is great to have him support this event.
Miguel, what was it like? We saw you on the field at Dallas Stadium, meeting Des Bryant, all that.
It's different, you know. NFL is a huge sport here in the U.S. In Puerto Rico, we are part of the United States, but Puerto Rico, one of the Gutos and Gutos, and follow NFL. It's getting bigger every year, but it's not like here. For us, being there with 100,000 some fans there, rooting for his team was an amazing experience for us.
Miguel and Freddie, I know the answer to this question, but the obvious question to boxing fans probably all over the world is, if Mayweather and Canelo don't take the fight, the next biggest fight is obviously Pacquiao Cotto.
The only way this fight can happen is if Freddie went to chair corners.
You know, it's definitely, I'm sure Miguel would love that one.
I'm not going back to 47.
I wouldn't get away with the catch weight this time. So, we weaken him a little bit. But, you know, the thing is, I think, you know, they're in the gym together sometimes, and it's okay for a little while, but then We have to separate them a little bit. There's a lot of stuff there. And I mean, there were opponents at one time, and they're somewhat friends now. But the thing is, our fighters are all ever friends. Maybe not. But the thing is, I respect both of them a lot, and they both have careers going on right now. And it doesn't look like they're going to meet each other. And Manny and Miguel both know that. You know, I'm behind them both very, very much, and I couldn't work both corners. And if that ever did happen, I would have to sit home and watch on TV. No, they can't spar.
Can you speak on that, Miguel? Because I mean, I was a collegiate athlete, and I hate the school that I lost for the championship game. So, can you elaborate on Manny Pacquiao?
I respect.
And he actually hits your punching bag.
I respect Freddie. I respect Manny enough to. They always been a gentleman with me, with my family, with my career, and all I have to say to them is thank you for respecting me. Thank you for the way they being with me, and that's all I have to say.
A follow-up for you, considering the fight is in Texas and you've been able to sell over 50% of it already, does that go to show how much you've actually gained the respect of fans, even considering that Mexico is the biggest rival in Puerto Rico?
I've been a fan of Mexican boxers my whole life, and I feel a lot of respect for Mexico. I love this place, and being accepted by their community is another accomplishment for me.
James, this is in your, this is your home turf, and certainly you must have sold some of those tickets as well. And your last fight was in Texas. How important it is to you to get back to those fans in Texas that know you and show them a different fight this time?
Most definitely, yes. I'm overwhelmed for the opportunity, but more than ever, I'm anxious to get back.
Can you speak to the catchweights? And I want your personal opinion. I was at the Cotto Canelo fight, and when I saw Canelo take his shirt off, I was like, wow, this guy's a light heavyweight. And I looked at you in the other corner, I'm like, this guy's literally 160. Can you speak to, do you think that catch weights are good and bad? And is there a problem with making weight? And then when you wake up Saturday night, the guy is 30 pounds heavier.
I've been in both sides of the plate. You know, some people on my side using against me. And but it's what it is, you know. If Freddie he's going to look for the benefit for his the guy who is in charge, his boxer, you know. And if I know from the beginning, if I knew from the beginning that I didn't get able to get to 145, I didn't sign the contract. I said yes in the beginning, in the first, and then in the day of signing the contract, and then make any kind of criticism to during the road to the fight is a thing that you have to be not professional to do it, you know. If you say yes the first day, you have to maintain and keep your word the whole way.
And Fred, do you want to ask?
You know, I actually don't like catch weight, but the thing is, we have used it to benefit our fighters, and you know, we're always looking out to get the best for your fighter. It's like I'm here with Miguel right now, and I'm always out for his best interest, for 100% behind him. And at that time, I was with Pacquiao, and Pacquiao was gonna, you know, we can drop a couple more rounds because he's a lot bigger and stronger guy than Pacquiao. And so I mean, catch weight's a part of life. It's legal. It's part of boxing at this point of our lives. Just I would like to get rid of it, yes, but I don't think it's gonna go away anytime soon.
And James, same question. I wanted to ask you about Canelo's weight going going up 20 pounds the back of the fight, and you walking in, well, you gained some weight as well, but I'm just speaking of Canelo's weight. At 155, maybe at 180, imagine the fight.
At the end of the day, I felt like Canelo prepared himself for a great fight. And he hydrated the right way. His team was there from 100%. So at the end of the day, man, when it comes down to just being 100% prepared on every level, they came to do a successful, great job.